Well, we made it to Schiphol Airport in the Netherlands, and now a quick 20-minute train ride will take us right into Amsterdam Center. Amsterdam Central is a very busy area with trains departing to all parts of Europe. And we'll be back here in a couple of days to catch a train to Warsaw, Poland. And Phyllis picked up our tram tickets that we'll be using for the couple of days that we'll be here before we head out. Amsterdam is a real crowded city. Way too many people here. Hotels, restaurants, shops, and trams definitely show discontent for the tourists. And of course, in all big cities, you're going to find all walks of life.
Om terug naar hem te komen, niet dat je dood moet, maar dat je relatie met hem hebt, want hij houdt van je.
Now that we're settled in Amsterdam, I think a little lunch would be all right. And right after lunch, we decided to take a walk down the street to see if we can't locate our coffee shop that we used to come to 10 years ago when we were here, called the Double Reggae. And buy all of your smoking paraphernalia right here. And we located the Double Reggae coffee shop, and it doesn't seem like anything has changed. When in Amsterdam, you can buy all types of marijuana right here. It's about 15 euro for 3 grams, or close to $20. Now this young lady has some big plans going on for later. There are all kinds of coffee shops that line the street, like this one right here that we used to visit 10 years ago. And another coffee house is the Bulldog, but not as friendly as the Double Reggae. And no matter how rich a city is, there's is always the homeless. An important tip when in Amsterdam is to beware that this is a bike trail, and if you step out into it without looking, you're going to get run over. The last two times we were here, we stayed at the Ibis, but we decided to stay in town in one of the older hotels. Well, after spending a couple hours in the coffee shop, we decided to go check into our hotel. This should be interesting. But before checking into our hotel, we decided to stop off at Amsterdam Square, or commonly known as Dam Square. This is where all the street vendors and people gather to party and just have a good time. And of course, the world famous Madame Tussauds Wax Museum of New York, London, Hollywood, and here in Amsterdam. And this is a few photos of us when we were here 10 years ago when we visited the Wax Museum. Amsterdam was saved devastation during World War II, so there are still some really beautiful architectural buildings that remain. The meaning of the three X's that you see throughout Amsterdam seems to have been lost in time. Some say it is the Amsterdam's coat of arms. Others believe that the St. Andrew's crosses refer to the three dangers of old Amsterdam faced: fire, floods, and the Black Death. Hey, Harry Krishner, alive and well. The National Monument is a 1956 World War II monument on Dam Square in Amsterdam. It's a National Remembrance of the Dead ceremony is held at the monument every year on the 4th of May to commemorate the casualties of World War II and subsequent armed conflicts. Well, we located our hotel and noticed this little bench outside with this little sign on it. I guess we were also lucky to get a hotel room on one of the canals. I didn't get any video of inside the room, but it was a basic queen bed. Room was about 15 by 15, real small, and no elevator, so you had to haul your luggage up about four flights of stairs. And this is what it looked like going out. And this is the hotel van owner. course, right outside the hotel, there are plenty of restaurants, but we chose this one, Teddy's Corner, after a friend of mine, and we did eat quite a bit here. And the next day, we continued with our roaming around the city, starting first with a nice breakfast. And Phyllis did need to get a little bit of shopping done. The streets are real narrow as they cross over the canals. This street is just before our hotel around the corner. There are a lot of beautiful sights to take in while you're in Amsterdam. The crowd you see on the other side of the canal here is actually trying to get into the Anne Frank house. I don't know what the big deal is about her. She really didn't contribute anything to the war. Let's go across the canal to get a better look at this. Okay, here we are outside the Anne Frank house at the Anne Frank statue. We did visit the Anne Frank house the last time we were in Amsterdam. Here's a couple of pictures, but no cameras allowed. I had to sneak these two. And while walking past the crowd, Phyllis looks down and picks up a 50 euro, which was about $64 at that time. It appeared to be about a 2-hour wait to get into the Anne Frank house. I'm not sure what the name of this church was, but it was a really beautiful architecturally designed building, so we just had to go in and check it out. And there's nothing like good Amsterdam street food to keep you going on a busy walking schedule. The temperature while we were there was in the upper 70s. Hi everybody, wish you were here. There are a lot of canals in Amsterdam, so you best carry a tourist map so you know exactly where you're going. That way. A lot of places in Amsterdam have their individual paint schemes and architectural designs. You'll find Gothic, Baroque, and Futuristic. Since I've got you on we found another little restaurant right in the heart of town that we stop and have ourselves another lunch on our last day here. I'm not sure what this was or what that is, but it looked good on the menu, so we bought them. We're now located in Rembrandt Square. Rembrandt Square was established in 1668 and built from the remnants of the old city port. And if guys need the urge to urinate, we have these public urinals right here. Well, it's getting late now. We're going to head back to the hotel because we are going to board a train tonight and head to Warsaw, Poland. So join us on part 2.